Hi, I'm Dr. Brian Lipworth, and I'd like to present to you today our paper published in Allergy looking at the effects of dupilumab on quality of life burden in patients with refractory type 2 high unified airways disease who had severe asthma and associated chronic rhinosinusitis with nasal polyps. There was a 4-week run-in period on ICS LABA and intranasal corticosteroid, followed by 12 weeks on dupilumab. 12-week washout off dupilumab with lab visits made at baseline week 12 and week 24. The first data slide in the upper panel shows the effect on quality of life in the upper airway, SNOT 22, and the lower airway at AQLQ, showing both statistically significant and clinically relevant improvements, greatly exceeding the respective MCID values, and in the lower panel showing effects on symptoms and the upper airway as nasal symptom score and the lower airway as the ACQ score. The next slide shows the effect on type 2 inflammation in the lower airway as fractional exhaled nitric oxide, showing highly significant suppression, and in the upper airway as nasal nitric oxide, where there was a significant increase. The reason being is that when you shrink the polyps, improve osteomedial complex patency, this flushes nasal nitric oxide out of the sinuses. The next slide shows significant and clinically relevant improvements in airflow obstruction in the upper airway as peak nasal inspiratory flow and the lower airway as peak expiratory flow, and as well as being significant statistically, these exceeded the minimal clinical important differences. So in conclusion, we found that dupilumab produced clinically relevant and significant improvements in upper and lower airway outcomes in terms of quality of life symptoms, airflow obstruction in association with reduced nasal polyp size and associated amelioration of osteomedial complex patency in our patients with type 2 high unified airways disease. Thank you for watching this video.